What's up, soldiers? Chris here, CaribbeanPod.com. Always a pleasure having you guys here in the kitchen with me, just putting the finishing touches on what I call the simplest, the easiest, the most ridiculously flavorful curry shrimp you'll ever make. Stay tuned, you're gonna love this one, man. And you see that gravy? You see that gravy? All right, stay till the end. I've got 2 tablespoons of olive oil in my little pot here. And I will be using a metal spoon. So those of you that freak out, you can turn off the video at this point. Right away, and this is something very quick. The heat is on low, eh? Quick, fast, tasty, all them kind of elements. We've got an onion, diced up really small. And that is a medium onion. I've got here 4 cloves of garlic that I crushed. Move that around. And if you want to use coconut oil, if you want to use vegetable oil, you can certainly use any of those. I like cooking with olive oil. I'm gonna let that sweat down there for about 3 minutes. And while it does that, I have here 2 habanero peppers. I like it spicy. I like my curry shrimp spicy. So I'm rocking 2 habanero peppers, seeds and everything. Now remember, if you have scotch bonnet pepper, if you have jalapeno, whatever pepper you have and you like using, be mindful to wash your hands with soap and water after. The onion is nice and soft. You can see that garlic just slightly started to take on some color. Here's where we're gonna go in with that Caribbean green seasoning. And my Caribbean green seasoning is just pretty much a blend or a puree. I keep saying this time and time again whenever we do videos. It is a puree of all the herbs. And just about every home in the Caribbean have a version of this. So any sort of herbs you like using in your dishes, along with garlic and pimento peppers, and it just the body of just about every dish we do in the Caribbean. And yeah, our French brothers got a piece, and our Spanish sisters got sofrito. You know, the English-speaking Caribbean, we do just green seasoning. That is the way we call it, yeah? I'm just gonna give this another minute. I'm gonna crank up my heat to medium now. Time for some anchar masala. And if you visit your favorite Caribbean grocery store, you'll find that that is a teaspoon of that. And it has these sort of notes of dry roasted cumin or jeera. If you can't source that anchar masala, let's just give it, it has a smokiness to it as well too. And most masala or curry dishes will have that in there just to pull out a whole bunch of different layers of flavor. If you can't source that anchar masala, you can use roasted, ground roasted cumin or jeera. Now it's time to add your curry powder. 1-2 tablespoons of curry powder. And we're just gonna give that a good mix. We wanna sort of fry or toast the, well, both the curry powder and the anchar masala, sort of waking up all the different spices which makes up those two elements there, yeah? So my heat is on medium, as I said. I want to give this about 2 or 3 minutes. I don't want to burn anything. And you'll notice a couple things. It will get darker, as you're noticing there, and it will start to clump together. That is totally normal. I'm going to turn my heat back down to low for a minute and just let that do its thing there for a couple more minutes. I ended up adding another tablespoon of oil because I really want this to cook out. We've got a nice paste here now. So we've bloomed all the spices which makes up that curry. Now it's time to cook out the rawness of the curry. And to do so, we need water. 1 cup of water. Yeah, it looks like a lot of water, but turn the heat back up to medium. It may look like a lot of water at this point, but we're creating a sort of a gravy or a base to sort of poach the shrimp in. Shrimp is notorious for cooking, for cooking too fast and for being overcooked, to be honest with you. And this is the sort of step we will take to prevent that from happening. Just wanna sort of scrape the bottom of the pot here. And I'm telling you, the kitchen is already smelling wicked, yeah? I'm going in with sea salt. You can use whatever salt you're comfortable using. And we need some black pepper. And to help give this some body, well, even more body, because remember, We've got all that onion in there, the garlic and everything else. It's gonna give it that body. I want a nice thick gravy sauce. I'm going in with one tomato diced up really fine. And besides giving it body, it helps to balance all the flavors, the acidity in that tomato. Yeah, it will add a lot to this dish. So we're just gonna give that a little quick stir. We bring that up to a boil and we're gonna reduce it. Turn it down to medium and reduce it down for about 5 minutes. And you're wondering about the shrimp? Well, the shrimp, it's already been peeled and deveined. I don't know if you guys can see there, white on white is not the best sort of color, but peeled and deveined. I'm using big shrimp. You can use small shrimp. You know, some people claim that small shrimp is sweeter. Yo, if you're accustomed with small thing, well, you know, you rock your small thing. I like it big on thing, all right? So we can bring it up to a boil and reduce it. Gotta appreciate the flavors and the scent and everything you're getting from this. Here's where now we're gonna go in with those shrimp. Peeled, deveined, washed with lemon juice. And if you want to hear, Chris, where's the seasoning? Remember, we started off with that green seasoning in there, eh? So whoever wants to complain about lack of seasoning, check yourself. And speaking about complaint, I have had complaints about the condition of my stove lately. Chris, your stove dirty. Well, listen, Linda. That dirty stove means people eating good. There's all kind of food cooking here. And it's kind of like, don't come wrong here no more. Hit the road, Jack. When it comes to Uber Eats. Uber Eats ain't showing up here no more. It's people, yo, Israel food cooking here. That's why that stove kind of, it's looking kind of dirty according to you. But say what? It will get clean, but we're eating good. Yeah, and the whole idea, the reason why we did it like this is not to overcook the shrimp. So at this point, we do not want to overcook that shrimp. So all we need is about 3 minutes and it will shut the stove off. The residual heat will continue cooking and bringing down that there. And remember I told you guys about that sauce, that gravy? You'll have your white rice or your roti or whatever it is you have there ready for a nice little something, yeah? One more minute and then we'll finish things up. Sup, soldiers? Listen, if you enjoy this recipe, I'd really appreciate it if you hit subscribe and click that bell notification thing. If you've made the recipe, take a picture and send it to me, email address down here. I mean, trying to tell people the email address, them butts will take the address and do all kind of thing with it. And tag me on Instagram at Caribbean Pod. I really appreciate you guys and thanks for being in my kitchen with me today. Irie. And finishing up just means we're going to end with some more flavor. And that flavor is courtesy of, boom, we've got some cilantro. If you have shadow benny, rock the shadow benny. That is also called coriander. I know my European friends, they call that coriander. We're just gonna, you know what? I'm gonna turn the stove off. Boom, bam. And I'm gonna go in. Yo, my Guyanese brothers and sisters call that wiri peppers. The rest of the Caribbean, we call it coffee pepper because it has the sort of shape and color of coffee beans. And just like that, Uncle Chris just dropped on you guys there. The easiest, simplest, tasty curry shrimp you'll ever have. Now remember we added these wiri peppers at the end because when you're eating, pow pow, you burst them open and yo, it's pure fire, pure niceness. If you have bird's eye pepper, you can do the same thing. And we have Zaire just making noise as usual, just having to, yo, the boy just like to be known, boy, like to be heard, like to be seen, all kind of thing. Sooner or later, he'll have his own little YouTube channel. But for now, enjoy. Irie.